everybody. Today I'll be showing you how to interpret your results. I'll be referring to results from the toaster project because the instructions and data for this example project are in your account. To access your results, choose which concept you'd like to compare. I'll click the toaster using secondary steel and then go right to the results tab. So there are a few different results views, starting with the scorecard, which summarizes the results. Then there's the impacts via SBOM inputs, which displays the top 10 most impactful SBOM inputs in either the total millipoints or the carbon footprint. In this view, you can choose whether to display inputs as materials and processes, or as part name, or as the part ID. Then lastly, there's impacts by life cycle stage, which displays life cycle stages with the greatest impacts in either total millipoints or again the carbon footprint. The impact assessment results from the reference product lets us know where the opportunities are for environmental performance improvement and for product innovation. Clicking on the total impacts again, we can see that the greatest impacts from the reference are being caused by the manufacturing of the chromium steel. Looking at its carbon footprint, we can see the greatest impacts are being caused by energy in the use phase. Now that we know where the impacts are occurring, we can explore eco-design strategies for end-of-life and use phase to generate new product concepts that will have a better environmental performance than the reference. So I'm going to go back to the Concepts tab, where you can see that we've generated a number of new concepts, some that improve the environmental performance and some that do not. We selected the toaster with the improved power as the final concept, in which we changed the electrical system into a more energy-efficient system. So let's see how it compares to the reference. Jumping right to the results views, we see we've achieved a 20% performance improvement. Our guidance is that anything greater than a 10% improvement is a meaningful improvement. Be sure to visit the Learning Center for more information on interpreting results. Looking at the total impacts results view, we can see the energy in the use phase is causing only the second greatest impact. So let's see what happened to the carbon footprint. Even though we've only reduced the total impacts by 20%, we've actually reduced the carbon footprint by over 40%. Be sure to keep your project goals in mind to see if you've actually achieved them. When the design process ends is up to you. And that's how to use your results to address eco-design strategies to figure out how to design greener products. Make sure you subscribe to the Sustainable Minds channel for more demos and webcasts.